Welcome to the Pilgrim Library's tutorial on the JSTOR database. JSTOR uses different software than the other databases available to Defiance College Library users, so you may find this tutorial helpful even if you've used the other databases before. JSTOR has full-text access to thousands of academic journal articles and book chapters. It covers many topics but is especially good in the humanities, and has quite a few articles from 100 years ago or longer if you need historical content to use in your assignment. Like if you were doing a paper on the 1918 flu pandemic, or one on the 19th Amendment granting women the right to vote in 1920, you could impress your professor by referencing an article in your paper that was written at the same time those things were actually happening. To access JSTOR, go to the library's homepage, library.defiance.edu, which you see here, and click on this Database A to Z tab, and then select JSTOR from the menu, and click on Go. This is the JSTOR landing page. If you are trying to access it from off campus, at this point you would be asked to authenticate. That means you'll be asked to enter your name and barcode number from your Defiance College ID card. This lets the database check that you are a registered student at an Ohio college that has paid for access and are not a hacker. But since I'm recording this while on campus, I can't show you those off-campus screen views. Once you authenticate, you will have access for 2 hours. You can then log in again after the 2 hours are up. Okay, now we're in the database. Let's say you are writing a paper on racial justice for sociology class, but you want to focus on one aspect of the topic, microaggressions. So let's enter microaggressions. That got us 319 hits. But your professor said you have to use only journal articles for your paper. So we will click on the Journals box on the left here under Academic Content. And that will eliminate documents from sources that are not journals. That leaves us with 306 hits. Then you remember that your professor said you can't use any articles older than 10 years. So we'll enter 2010 and 2020 in these date range boxes and hit Apply. That leaves us with 238 hits. You may think about your topic and decide to limit it even more so you aren't wading through hundreds of articles. You want to focus on how microaggressions affect African Americans. One option would be to look in the bar on the left again, under Subject. If we click this box, African American Studies, that will limit the search to journals from the African American Studies field. Now we are left with 36 hits. We'll look at the first article called Racial Microaggressions, which was published in the Journal of Negro Education. How do we investigate whether this is a good article for a research paper or not? If we click on the title of the article, the screen will show more information, such as a full abstract describing what the article's about. And you could scroll down to view the bibliography of sources that the author used to write the article. Let's say you viewed these and decide that this article will work for your paper. Click here on Download PDF to bring up the actual article. You may see a box asking if you accept JSTOR's conditions before it will let you view. And here's the first couple pages of the article. Depending on the software on your device, often the icons to download or print the article are here in the upper right corner. Now let's X out of the PDF. Now we're back in the previous screen, and we'll scroll down and click on Cite This Item. A box will display showing you how to cite the article in your own bibliography according to the three major citation styles, MLA, APA, and Chicago. You can copy and paste that information into a Word document for use later. Let's X out of the citation box and scroll up and click here where it says Advanced Search. You can choose to use the Advanced Search mode instead of the simple one we just used. Now we'll look for articles written during the 1918 influenza pandemic. Let's enter influenza in the first box and pandemic in the second. It's recommended that you leave this box as content I can access instead of changing it to all content. If you were to change it to all content, you may be disappointed to retrieve articles you want but can't access. Defiance College pays for access to a partial subset of JSTOR, not the whole database. We'll scroll and check the relevant boxes, such as articles, and you may want to limit it to English unless you can read more than one language. We want articles published during the pandemic, so we'll limit the search by date, 1918 to 1919. You could also limit the search to a specific journal title with this box, or filter by field of study like we did in the first example, but I won't for this search. Let's go ahead and search on influenza and pandemic by clicking on the Submit Advanced Search box. We got 55 hits. You could also limit the search further by adding a term in the Search Within Results box. If we add soldiers there, the database will pick out articles from our results that mention outbreaks among men in the Army, which is where scientists think the pandemic started in the U.S. This tutorial has covered the basics of using JSTOR. If you need more help, please contact a librarian. From the library's homepage, click on Library Links, and then Staff Contact. That brings up a page with our contact information. Thanks for viewing our JSTOR tutorial.